Voila. I'm gonna roll my cart here. One thing I'm interested in is trying to do phase shifting with my own, as Todd said, clapping machine. And could I phase shift without, can the machine I build do the actual phase shifting? And so that's been fun and hard and confusing, but great challenges. And often I'll do that with a piece. I'll build something and sort of make rules in my head for what I'm trying to do. I was recently reading about synesthesia, and I think I have some weird version of that somehow is playing out in my brain as I make some of my work. Okay. This little ensemble. See if we can get going here.
Great.
How's everything sounding?
Sounds really good.
Cool.
Thank you.
So that was two quasi-percussion machines. One of the first things I built a couple years ago, I took to an event at ATA, Artist Television Access, in the Mission for a project Craig Baldwin is doing. And it's this bow and spring. So let's see if we can get this alive. Thing I did recording the album is I came up with these rules and went back to the old performance art days where we used to have a 5-minute rule, and we thought, well, after 5 minutes anything gets boring, and so just keep changing. And then I cut that down to 3 minutes, and then when we're listening back and Brian was remixing stuff, I was like, man, I should have practiced with stretching things out and being patient. And so let's see where something might go. if I gave it 10 minutes, say. So I did that once or twice out of the 4 hours of recordings, but you know, practice makes perfect. I got this machine I call the banjo. That's the chocolate grinder over there, is what I call it. And kind of come up with these weird names for everything for whatever reasons. I'm going to start, maybe often I'll start something by laying down a sort of ambient track and then let something be a rhythm or a solo kind of piece. So let's do a little ambient track first. Banjo. As I work with Clubfoot Orchestra, The percussionist is this guy, Gino Robert, who's an absolute genius. I mean, just it's such an honor to work with someone like that. And Gino is really taken to the banjo. So I feel like I'm onto something if Gino likes it. So I have that small harp you saw earlier with the chocolate grinder. And then I have my larger harp over here. And it is just a wicked little monster that I don't feel like I ever really got the hang of it. It's just so crazy. But well, let's see what often the machines act up and they do what they do. And then I just sort of roll with it. And that's sort of a rule I came up with too. Like, oh, you have to let the machines do what they do. And it makes me improvise and sort of riff on stuff. Getting a rhythm here.